The names of Allah are all those names that refer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself and refer to one of his perfect attributes that exist in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, such as Al-Qadir, the All-Powerful. So the All-Powerful is a name, but it refers to an attribute which is what? Might and power. Might and power. So the name Al-Qadir, the All-Powerful, refers to an attribute which is Al-Qudra, the might and the power. The name of Allah, Al-Alim, the All-Knowing, even though, so the name is Al-Alim, the All-Knowing, it refers to an attribute of knowledge, the attributes of knowledge. The name of Allah, Al-Hakim, the Most Wise, refers to an attribute of wisdom. Al-Sami', the All-Hearing, refers to the attribute of hearing. Al-Basir, the All-Seeing, refers to vision and seeing. These names refer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself and his qualities of knowledge, wisdom, hearing, and sight. The attributes refer to one thing, which is the attribute itself. So a name of Allah indicates two things, the name and the attribute. But the attribute requires a name. Some of you are already confused. Let me take you to another level. If you're asked, like a student of knowledge, we always say asma wa sifat, the names and the attributes of Allah. Here is a question for you. What is the difference, or what are the differences between the names of Allah and the attributes of Allah? Okay, that's a question. That's the first question we want to answer tonight. We need to know that. What do we mean when we say the names? What do we mean when we say the attributes? I told you a minute ago that the name of Allah, As-Sami'a, the All-Hearing, that's a name. As-Sami'a is the All-Hearing. It refers to an attribute which is called what? Hearing. Al-Basir, the All-Seeing, it refers to Allah himself and it refers to an attribute of Allah, which is the sight. The sight. You're getting that? So let's answer the question, brothers and sisters in Islam. What is the difference between the names and the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The first difference, brothers and sisters in Islam, right here, is the name, or the names refer to two things. Refer to the essence, to Allah. As-Sami' is Allah. Al-Basir is Allah. And it also refers to an attribute. So when you say a name, then the name refers to Allah himself, the essence of Allah, an attribute of Allah. But what about the attribute? The attribute refers to one thing, which is the attribute. Al-Sam'a. Al-Basar. And for you to come up with an attribute, you must have a name. You're getting that? You must have a name. So that's the first difference. The first difference. A name refers to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself and an attribute. Or maybe attributes. One name, Al-Hakim, the All-Wise, requires knowledge too. The All-Wise require, khibra, experience, if we may use this pertaining to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So one name could mean more than one attribute. But for you to produce an attribute, you must have a name. Or Allah tells you this is an attribute. That's the first difference. The attributes refer to one thing, which is the attribute itself. So a name of Allah, look at this white bullet there. A name of Allah indicates two things, and an attribute indicates only one thing. So it is said, a name includes an attribute, and an attribute requires a name. That's the first difference. But the second difference, very important. Pay attention to this. You may derive attributes from the names, but not vice versa. I'll explain, no panic. Like a minute ago, I said, As-Sami'a, the all-hearing. What attribute did we derive from the name of Allah, the all-hearing? Hearing. Al-Hakim, that's a name. Al-Hakim is a name of Allah. What attribute did we derive? Derive, يعني اشتقاق, اشتقاقنا. Wisdom, the attribute of wisdom. طيب, what attribute did we derive from al-Basir, sight? The all-seer, sight. But we cannot derive names from attributes. One of the things when we debate with Christian and Jews, and if they want to insult Allah to make you upset, they tell you, listen, I don't like to worship a God who blots, a God who deceives. If you read the Mus'haf, وَمَكَرُوا وَمَكَرَ اللَّهِ, they blotted and Allah blotted. So now the attribute of blotting is confirmed for Allah. The question, can you call Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the blotter? No, you can't. You cannot. Astaghfirullah. Say subhanallah. Say subhanallah. Why? Because we do not derive names from the attributes. But this is what we call sifat muqabala, an attribute of facing, a confrontational. Because imagine the created beings, they blot. What is blotting? What does blotting mean? What does blotting mean? What does blotting mean? At-tadbiru bi-khafa, that you do something in secret, that no one knows about it. That's what blotting is. That you scheme, you cook something to your enemy, to somebody that you're trying to harm without them knowing it. So imagine their blood, that created blood, and Allah doesn't know about it. No, Allah blots too. Meaning Allah knows what they are doing. Meanwhile, they do not know what Allah is doing. You're getting that. So it's sifat muqabala. It's an attribute to face, confront. إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ يُخَادِعُونَ اللَّهَ وَهُوَ خَادِعُهُمْ. Indeed, the hypocrites, they think, the hypocrites, they deceive Allah, and Allah deceives them. Now the people, they say, Allah is the deceiver. Can you say Allah the deceiver? No, you can't say that. You cannot say that. Why? Because of that, we cannot derive names for Allah from attributes, from actions. We don't do that. You're getting the point. But now, does Allah deceive? Yes. Well, what would you say if the hypocrites, what is what is deception? What do you mean by deception here? That you try to trick the one in front of you, that the hypocrites are tricking Allah. Can you say that? Astaghfirullah. Say subhanallah. The attribute here is the attribute. But the rule that I want you to memorize, that I want you to understand, that you may derive attributes from one name, but you cannot do vice versa. Here it is. We may derive attributes from the names, but we cannot derive names from the attributes. Say, for example, they blot and Allah blots. The Quran affirms the attribute of blotting to Allah. But we cannot derive the name the blotter from the attribute of blotting. the coming and the descending are attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It was mentioned in the Quran, but we cannot derive names from these attributes. We cannot call Allah the comer, the descendant. Of course, this differs from the names of Allah, which refer to an attribute by itself. So this is the second difference, brothers and sisters, in Islam. So what was the first difference? Huh? Come on, students, what? A name refers to two things. Allah, the essence, is that the divine essence of Allah. When I say Sami', who's a Sami'? Allah. And it refers to an attribute of Allah as well. Two things. An attribute refers by itself. It stands by itself. طيب. The second difference between the names and the attributes, we may derive attributes from the name, but we cannot do vice versa. We cannot derive names from the attributes. Number three, consequently, the attributes are way more than the names. Which is bigger now? The attribute, if every name has an attribute or more than one attribute, so the attributes are what? Many. Our knowledge of Allah's attributes is vaster than our knowledge of His names, since each name implies an attribute, but not all the attributes double as a name. For example, Allah has attributes indicate some of His numerous actions like coming, going, taking, catching, using force. We attribute them to Allah because they are mentioned in the Quran and the Sunnah, but they don't have names. But we do not refer to Him by names that indicate that. Like I said, I cannot call Allah the blotter. I cannot call Him the common. I cannot call Him the descendant because there is no name. You understand? But the attribute is there. Consequently, the attributes are way more than the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The last difference, brothers and sisters in Islam, when we call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we use the names. وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى فَدُعُوهُ بِهَا. To Allah belongs the most beautiful name, so call upon Allah using these names. When you call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you don't use the attribute by itself, but you call يا سميع, يا بصير, يا قوي, يا حميد, يا مجيد, يا غني. So when you say يا, you use a name. But for you to use the attribute, you must use something before it. You cannot use the attribute. You cannot call upon Allah saying, O sight, O seeing, O wisdom. You cannot call upon Allah using the attribute by itself, but using something with it, like Allahumma bi'ilmika al-ghaybi, bi'ilmika al-ghayba, wa qudratika ala al-khalqi, by, like fi Sunan al-Nasa'i, calling upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala directly. And this is the second difference, the third difference that we have, brothers and sisters in Islam. So this is a little warm up here. We differentiated between the names and the attributes. A name refers to Allah and an attribute. But the attribute refers to just an attribute. We cannot derive names from the attributes, but we can derive attributes from the names. We call upon Allah straight using the names, but for me to call upon Allah using the attribute, I must add something before it. These are the differences, brothers and sisters in Islam.